Welcome to Space Engineers. Welcome back on the Xbox, on the Series X, with a short tutorial on spawning planets. I've seen this one mentioned on the Facebook group. I've seen it mentioned online, and I thought I would give you a bit of an intro on how to spawn planets, but also explain that you can have more than three planets in a Space Engineers scenario. What you can't do, though, is have more than three planet types on console. Let's kick off with a new game. So we go to the new game menu and we go to custom. We open up custom and we look down and we want empty world. We're going to go into creative. And we're not going to bother with any mods or anything like that. We are just literally going to select empty world. And we're going to hit X. And we're going to start this empty world off. And here we are. This is a Space Engineers scenario devoid of any planets whatsoever. And you can check that by going into your admin screen with the right bumper and Y. And choosing the entity list. Then moving down to select from grids to planets. And you'll see there's absolutely nothing. So let's get started populating this with the three planet types that I want to choose for this particular scenario. So to begin with, click in the right stick and pop open your spawn menu. You'll see it on the right trigger under menu. We open the spawn menu and then from the drop box, you can go from items to procedural asteroids to planets. Select planets. And then we're going to start with one of my favorite planets, Pertum. Now, once you've got Pertum selected with A, tap down on the left stick and you'll see select size. Now, you can choose the size of the planet. So let's go for 69.50 kilometers. Then you have the generation seed. Now you can type numbers or whatever you want into that seed. I'm going to tap random generate seed a couple of times and I'm going to hit the spawn menu. That won't immediately spawn the planet. It will spawn the planet cursor. And you can use this like you would any other blueprint or paste. You can push it backwards and forwards and so on and so forth. I want it about there. So once I'm happy, I press the right trigger, and here's Pertum. Now, if I want to move around, I'm going to have to go into spectator mode because this is way too slow. So, let's press in the right stick. This time, let's go to view. Let's toggle spectator mode on, confirm it. And now, you'll see that I'm in spectator mode, and I'm going to move pretty quick when I start moving. So what we want to do is hold down the right bumper and tap up 1, 2, 3 times. Still not fast enough. 3 more times. Still not fast enough. 3 more times. Do it in threes. That might be fast enough. Let's do it 1, 2, 3. Now that's way too fast, but that's good for moving around space and getting into position for the next planet. So with Pertum just a dot on the horizon, click in your right stick and go back to menu. Choose open spawn menu. And this time we're going to bring in the alien planet. It's only going to be 19 kilometers, but we're going to generate a seed again. And you'll see that we're taken back to where we were. But because we've set up our spectator cam now, we can move around as we like, quite quickly, holding down the right bumper. Pushing up or down on the right stick will change the speed of the camera, as I just said. So from here, we're going to bring in this planet. And there we go, a tiny planet. Oh, tiny planet. if you hear any noise in the background, as you well may have known, if you remember, if you've been keeping up with my community tab or listening to me as I talk about things, one of my big older cats, Mal, passed away just a few weeks ago. We now have a new kitten, and this new kitten is quite boisterous. And also the spitting image of Mal when he was a kitten, so that's a bit interesting. Anyway, we're now going to go for Triton. And you'll see, you'll go straight back to where your engineer is, but don't worry about that. We're going to change the size to 120 kilometers. We're going to pop the generation seed a couple of times, hit spawn, get our planet cursor, and zoom off around Space Engineer space. And just slap in a planet where we want it. So, I'm just going to slap this planet in there. So now we have planets. If we bring up the admin menu again, the right bumper on white, you can go from grids to planets in the entity list, and you'll see we've got Alien, Perton, and Triton. Now, if we click in and stay in spectator mode for this as well, you'll find going into spectator mode will make spawning planets a lot easier. You won't be flying around the universe on your jetpack. You'll see that now we can't spawn any more planets of a different type, but what we can do is we can spawn another Pertum. So let's spawn a Pertum that's 69.50 kilometers. And now you'll see that when I go to spawn in Pertum, it spawns the planet Triton, another 120, generate a new seed, spawn, pull away, randomly fly off into the distance, Triton, open my planets menu, boom, one alien, two Pertum, two Triton. Go even faster as well. Pull right away and tap. There we go. So now you can see right in here. If we drop into the atmosphere, the planets. All the way in the distance. We bring up our list of grids again. Under the entity list, hit planets. You see we have an alien planet, three instances of Pertum, and two of Triton. So you can have more than three planets in a Space Engineers scenario, but you cannot on the Xbox have more than the three planet types. But still, this means that you could create a scenario where you've got far more planets to explore. Even though they're the same planet, the generational seed that you choose will determine the random nature of the planet and various other factors. That is how you do it. Pretty simple, pretty easy. And if you want to maintain an idea of where things are without having to just randomly place them, you could go down to the planet surface, open up your menu with the inventory button, go to GPS. When you're on the planet's surface, hit X, create a new GPS marker, and do that for every planet, and then you'll get a decent distance between the planets. You can actually set it up so you know that you are 10,000 kilometers away from Pertum when you're on Triton, and so on. And that's it. That's all you need to know about planet spawns, the amount of planets you can have, and the type. Hopefully you'll find this of some interest and of some use when you create your own saves, or even if you're playing around on one home system and you want to put a new planet in. You can, but it'll only be one of the three kinds of planets that are already in the game. That's all for now. Stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Join me again for more Space Engineers content, as I will eventually be going back to my save on the new player guide. Bye for